welcome to another edition of Health Matters. I'm Dr. Bruce Karlin, and I'm delighted tonight to have as my guest Dr. John Abramson, who I've known for quite a few years. And we're going to do something a little bit different tonight, in that we're going to do a two-part show. We haven't done that in over 200 tapings that we've done, because I think Dr. Abramson has stuff to tell us that is of vital importance. Welcome to the show.
Bruce, thank you for having me, and it's a pleasure to see you. I think we've known each other for about 50 years or more.
At least. I was going to say that part of the reason that I wanted to grab you onto the show is that you gave grand rounds at St. Vincent Hospital. And after your grand rounds, one of the third-year residents came up to me and said, that was the best grand rounds we've had. And I thought, my gosh, this is so accessible to the lay public that we should present this. And I talked with our folks at the Worcester District Medical Society and said, can we get John on? And now you're here.
Thank you.
So tonight, I thought... First off, you should know that Dr. Abramson has won awards as chair of family medicine at Leahy Clinic and taught at Harvard Medical School for 25 years, and left practice in 2002 to write his first book, Overdose America, and now has published his second book, which I'm going to show you here. It's called Sickening, and it's about how we go about qualifying our drugs. And I thought we'd start, I'm going to let you start. Where do we start? How do we put this into context?
Well, I think we need to start by framing the problem, because the general message that we get about American healthcare is that though it's expensive, we have first shot at innovation, and we are generating the most innovation, and that path of access to the greatest amount of innovation is going to lead us to the best health. And in fact, that's not true. Progress is not necessarily a social good. It may be innovation that creates more profits, but doesn't help society. And when we look at what's happened in healthcare since 1980, how the United States healthcare and health stacks up against the other wealthy countries, it's just shocking how far we've fallen behind in the last 53 years or so.
So you say we're paying a lot, and yes, we do have some innovation. There's no doubt about the innovation. I mean, the innovation is incredible stuff, but it's not making a big difference on the bottom line, how much the overall health of the Americans are.
That's exactly. Maybe we could go to the first slide, and folks can get a dramatic picture of what's going on here.
How you doing there, Frank? Can we show that?
So if you look at this slide, this is life expectancy at birth for Americans in the green line and citizens of 10 other wealthy countries in the blue line. And you can see back around 1980 or 82, we were very close. The United States in green
was... So that's on the far left of the chart is where we started.
Right, right. And that's where we were when I went into practice and probably when you went into practice as well. And Americans were doing just about as well as the citizens of other wealthy countries. But if you look at that chart, as you move over to the right, you can see the separation in the aqua portion of the chart, you can see the separation between the green line and the blue line. And that means that the other countries are gaining years of life expectancy much faster than Americans are. So we get to the end of the aqua line, and we're at 2014, and there's approximately 3.4 years difference between Americans. Americans are living 3.4 years less than the citizens in the other wealthy countries. Now we get into that grayish area between 2014 and 2019.
So that's before COVID.
It's before COVID, but it's after Obamacare is implemented, and 40% of the Americans who were uninsured become insured. So this was a tremendous breakthrough in social justice and equity in medicine. But if you look at the line of longevity in the United States between 2014 and 2019, our longevity actually went down. So 40% of the uninsured Americans get coverage, and our longevity goes down, while the longevity in the other countries is still going up. Now, that's a mystery, and we're going to have to talk about that. But then we get to COVID in 2020 and 21, and longevity Americans just plummets in comparison to the people in the other wealthy countries. They lose some ground in the first year of COVID, 2020, but they recover, and by 2021, they're back to increasing their longevity, and Americans are still falling behind. So by the time we get to the end of 2021, Americans are living 6.3 years less than the citizens in the other countries.
So why is that?
Well, let's just take a look. Let's turn up the microscope a bit on that, if we could go to the next slide. So I'm sorry about the overlay, but if you look at this, the United States, at the top line in green, the United States was spending over $12,000, $12,900 per person per year for healthcare in 2021. And the people in the blue line, which is the average of the other 10 wealthy countries, are spending about $6,000 per person per year on healthcare.
And hearkening back to the last slide, they're getting six more years of life out of it.
6.3, correct. If you take that difference of $6,900 per person per year that Americans are spending